So today we are painting, what's this guy's name? Dr. Orontis, another Reaper figure from the Pathfinder range. And I don't know why they call him a doctor. I guess it's a Pathfinder thing, but he is a very old school, traditional wizard. He even got a little owl on his shoulder. So, painting this guy for the second time. Started off doing the cloak blue, and I instantly did not like it. I'm gonna go with more of a purple color. And so we're gonna mix some Warlord Purple with some Hexed Lichen. And don't know exactly what I want yet. Let's see. Let's just start with that and get to it. Sometimes I plan things out, sometimes I just, you know, go with whatever I have. You know, I gotta put paint on the miniature and that will help me determine exactly how I want to paint it. For example, I started painting this blue because that's what I thought I wanted, but I instantly did not like it, so didn't know that until I put the blue on. But we are starting with the base coat here. I'm not starting with the shade layer like normal because this cloak is just very straight. It doesn't have a bunch of big wrinkles in it. Deciding if I want to go darker or not. But we'll base coat this and then I'll figure out where I want to go from there. I'm gonna stick with this currently, this color, and just mixed in a little bit more of the Warlord Purple in. Start working on the highlights. When you're working on highlights like this on something, you know, big obvious folds, it's very easy to go this way with the highlights, up and down. However, that makes it very hard to blend in. I mean, I'm doing a little base coat here, but what actually you wanna do, need my paint a little thinner. If you go this way, it helps to blend the colors in easier when they start going into those recesses. Because rather than a straight line, you have a broken pattern, which visually breaks it up. A little mistake there. So we'll just do this. And then figure out where we're gonna go next. One more highlight with more Warlord Purple added. As you can see, as we go closer towards the higher highlights, you can see we're applying the highlights to a smaller and smaller surface area. That's the whole point of highlighting. I'm not bothering with the inside of the cloak right now. I base coated it, but I just did that to make sure I don't miss any black primer spots. I'm actually gonna paint it a different color. The thing with a figure like this, it's very easy to paint because it's just large, very unobstructed surface areas, but it's really screams out for detail work. Because if you just paint it, it's easy to paint, but it looks very flat and boring. So we're gonna have to go back in with this and spice it up with a lot of extra details. One more highlight, a little extra Warlord Purple, and then we'll move on. For shade, I mixed a little bit of the Hexed Lichen with the Warlord Purple with a little black. And I kind of picked the wrong colors for this paint job here, since I went with the lichen, the purple. They're kind of two different shades, so I didn't really highlight this. I got more of an iridescent look. Hoping I could fix this. Maybe with some glazes. You know, that's what we're going to do. We're going to glaze a little bit of the Hex Lichen over this once I'm done with this shade. And for the inside, I'm going to do the same color. I'm going to add more black to... get a piece of static grass on my brush there. Add a bit more black and really darken it as it goes deeper inside the cloak. So I got a little of the hex lichen thinned, and I'm just going over the cloak here basically the same way as I would if I was using a ink glaze. I'm using for the same purpose, sort of to bring down that warlock purple to a bit more useful color. So see, that helps a lot because that brought down the brightness of the warlock purple. That's looking better. Right, we're gonna move on to the robe and get back to the cloak a little bit later. For his robes, I don't know exactly what color I want. I know I want them blue. So I'm just gonna start with the darkest blue I have, which is game color Stormy Blue, and work my way up from there. And then eventually I'll hopefully get to whatever color I want. Who knows what that will be? At the moment I'm thinking something on the darker side. I'm not sure exactly how dark. After the Stormy Blue, I actually put on some Dark Prussian Blue, which I forgot I had. Covers a little bit better than the Stormy Blue. Stormy Blue tends to be a little kind of glossy, a little funky to work with. But anyway, now mixed in some Model Color Intense Blue. It's about a 50-50 mix with the Dark Prussian Blue. And leaving the Dark Prussian Blue as a recess, deepest shade color. So just picking out the major folds right now. As I'll always notice how much surface area I'm covering up now, as opposed to when we start getting into the upper highlights. So you see how much I'm covering compared to them, and how long it's taking as well. And also, as usual, the thinner your paint, the more layers it takes to cover up and work up to whatever color you're currently painting. So I'm not going over everything just once, I'm going over it a couple times, because my paint is not super thin right now. I'm not trying to paint super Golden Demon quality guys here, but also not doing rank and file. Oh, forgot his hat. Normal procedure would call for me going straight to Intense Blue here. However, Intense Blue is a little flat, kind of lackluster in color. So instead I mixing in some Magic Blue, game color Magic Blue, into the mixture I just used. And we're going to use that as a highlight, which is a small amount to the previous mixture. Because the Magic Blue is a bit more, it's brighter, it's more intense in color, ironically, than the Intense Blue. One more highlight with more Magic Blue added. At this point, I'm not sure if this is going to be the final highlight or not. So just kind of put it on. Once it's on, I'll have a better idea if I need to go higher or not. I think we're going to go one step more, mixing a little bit of a lighter blue. One final highlight, mixed in a little bit electric blue to the previous mix. I probably could have done white too. Just trying to hit the tops of the folds, don't want to overdo this one.
kind of went a little overboard with the highlights on this color once again, just like I kind of did with the back. I think I'm going to once again do another glaze, a glaze of blue ink, to kind of make it blend together a bit more, because that dark Prussian blue I left in the recesses was a little too extreme for my tastes. All right, onto the glaze now. Very thin blue ink. You notice it's not pooling. I'm not letting it pool anywhere. I'm doing an even coat. That's the main difference between a glaze and a wash. Glaze, nice even coat. Wash, you can theoretically flood the area in order to get the wash, you know, mostly in the recesses. But this is going to tone everything down, bring the shade up, and lower the highlights down so everything's a bit more uniform and softly blends everything together. That's a little better. All right, what's next? For the cloak, oh man, this is going to be hard to do on camera. Talking and doing careful precision work. For the cloak, I want to do some various symbols. Astrological symbols. I'm going to start by doing a circle. That's a very awful circle. But I'm doing this in with a model color purple, which is similar to the color I already used on the cloak, because I want this to be kind of subtle. We're going to put some different symbols on the cloak, which I have to do off camera. Sorry, it's just too hard to talk and try to do this. All right, got a bit more work done, easier to do without trying to talk. I just got some various astrological symbols and some wheel designs on the back of this thing. So just kind of filling in my wheels within wheels. And just putting various symbols here and there, following my astrological guidebook here. Once I get these marked in place, we'll go back over them and do a little bit of highlighting. But I do want this kind of subtle blending into the cloak. And we'll do another wash over these. I guess we'll find out in a moment. So when you're doing fine freehand work like this, it's usually easier if you start off with a color fairly similar to your base coat, almost exactly the same, and the first layer, like I just did, use that as basically just kind of blocking in where you want whatever your pattern is going to be, wherever you want that to go. I probably could have done a little bit darker with mine, but now going back over, mixed in a little bit of shocking pink, that previous mixture, and just going over the lines to define them better. I'm going to leave that first layer where it crosses into the recesses. I'm just going to leave that first layer as it is. So I went a little too light on on my little scroll work here. So I'm just going back once again with that hex lichen glaze, going over the cloak again to tone it down. I am losing some of my highlights here because I keep doing this glaze, but I mean, in the end, the scroll work, I mean, is going to hide all the highlights anyway, pretty much. So I had to make some more changes to the cloak just to darken my pattern even more. Went over it with a violet ink glaze, which added a bit more shade. And because I kind of lost some of my contrast, now I mixed in some black with that. And I'm going over that in the recesses. So really darkening things up now. But I do want this pattern to be subtle. But we're getting closer.